Yo soy de Cuba. Tú eres guyanés. Yo, tú, usted, él, ella. Now, let's learn los pronombres personales. Personal pronouns. These are the personal pronouns in Spanish. Yo. Remember that in the first class, I told you that we have more than one word for you. So here you have two of those. If I'm going to say you in an informal way, then I would say tú. But if I'm going to say you in a formal way, I wouldn't say tú. I would say usted. He, she, él, ella. We have two words for we, depending of the gender of a person. Masculine, nosotros. Feminine, nosotras. We have a next word here for you, for the plural, like when you say in English, you all or you guys. That word is ustedes. Ustedes is a plural for tú and the plural for usted also. We have two words for they, one for masculine and one for feminine. The masculine they, ellos, and the feminine they, ellas. Nosotros, as I told you just now, means we masculine, but not necessarily. When there is a group of men, yes, we use the word nosotros, but when there is a group where you can find female and male, then we would say nosotros too. We say nosotras when the group of persons only have female. Same thing for ellos. Ellos means they when there is a group of men. But when the group has male and female persons, then we say ellos too. Ellas means only they when the group only have female. Ser means to be in Spanish. I am in Spanish is yo soy. And why I'm writing yo between parentheses? Because the personal pronoun in Spanish is optional. You do not have to use it all the time. I use the personal pronoun when I want to emphasize something like I am. But if you simply want to say I am, you say soy. You are, tú eres, or simply eres. When you want to say you are, but formally, then you would say usted es, or simply es. Es also means he is or she is. So for singular, the verb to be has three forms. Soy, eres, es. For plural, nosotros or nosotras somos. We are, somos. You guys are, son. And son means also they are. Two forms of the verb to be in plural. Somos, son. Soy, eres, es, somos, son. Those are the five forms of the verb to be in simple present. Some examples now. Soy Juan. Soy de Cuba. Soy alto. I am Juan. I am from Cuba. I am tall. Eres María. Eres de Guyana. Eres baja. What's the meaning of eres? Exactly, you are. But you are formal or informal? Informal. So, eres María means you are María. But is María my friend? Most likely, because that's informal. Es Roberto. He is Roberto. Where is Roberto from? Es de Venezuela. What's Roberto's profession? Es doctor. You say doctor, we say doctor. Vamos a hacer el ejercicio 3, página 17. Escoja el pronombre lógico. Choose the more logical pronoun. For example, y lleva pantalones en is wearing pants? ¿Quién? Mónica. Who? Mónica. Lleva una falda azul. What's the personal pronoun that I use for Mónica? Exactly. In English. She, in Spanish, ella. Y ella lleva pantalones. ¿Quién? Mónica. Lleva una falda azul. ¿Es profesor aquí? ¿Quién? Raúl. No. Es estudiante. ¿Son mexicanos? Sí. Silvia y Nacho son mexicanos. What's the corresponding personal pronoun? 3. ¿Viejos? Old? No. Doña Eulalia y yo, Doña Eulalia and I, Doña Eulalia y yo somos muy jóvenes. 4. Señor Ruiz tiene bigote. ¿Verdad? ¿Verdad means really? ¿Y son estudiantes aquí? No. Pilar and Clara son estudiantes en Madrid. Possible answers. Ellos, usted, ellas, él, nosotros. And now another exercise. Ejercicio 4, página 17. And you can understand the numbers now. 4, 17. Complete los diálogos con la forma correcta del verbo ser. Complete the dialogues with the right form of the verb ser. Soy, es, somos, son. As you can see, eres, you are, informal, is not used in those dialogues. ¿Cómo se llama usted? I am Raúl Saucedo. ¿Quién es ella? Who? La chica de la blusa roja se llama Mónica. Ella y Carmen, that is, ellas, amigas. ¿Estudiantes ustedes? No. El profesor López y yo, that is, nosotros, profesores de la universidad. Now I'm inviting you to do this exercise from the website of Dos Mundos. You can find the link in the description of this video. When we were studying the clothing, we used the verbal form lleva, which means he or she is wearing. When we were studying how to describe people, we said tiene el pelo corto or tiene el pelo largo. Now, let's study the verbs llevar, to wear, and tener, to have. Now some examples. Ernesto lleva un saco gris. The suffix ito in Spanish, the ending ito in Spanish, means small. So, Ernestito is a familiar form of the name Ernesto. Ernestito lleva una camiseta blanca. Llevo una camisa verde. And that is true because I am wearing a green shirt. Algunos ejemplos. Tengo bigote y barba. Marta tiene el pelo negro y corto. Julio tiene la barba color café y el pelo largo. Ejercicio 1, página 13. Completa los diálogos con estos verbos. Me llamo, my name is, se llama, your name is, formal, his name is or her name is, llevo, I'm wearing, lleva, you are wearing, formal, he is wearing or she is wearing, llevan, you guys are wearing or they are wearing. ¿Cómo usted, Esteban Brown? Esteban, ¿cómo la amiga de Mónica? Carmen. ¿Y cómo se llama la profesora de español? Adela Martínez. ¿Qué ropa la profesora Martínez hoy? Un vestido rojo muy bonito. Bonito means pretty. Muy bonito means very pretty. Y Luis y Alberto, ¿qué ropa ellos? Camiseta y pantalones vaqueros. Y yo, pantalones vaqueros y un suéter. Persons and animals are either feminine or masculine in English. The objects are neuter. We do not have the concept of neuter in Spanish. In Spanish, everything is either masculine or feminine. This can sound a little bit weird for you because how come that table, mesa is feminine? How come that book, libro is masculine? Or in any case, why? The concept of gender is very important in any language, well, specifically in Spanish, that is the language that we are studying. So let's start studying el género gramatical, the grammatical gender. The gender of a specific noun affects all the other words related to that noun. For example, man, hombre, el hombre pequeño, the small man. Car, auto, el auto pequeño, the small car. But if I want to say the small woman, instead of el, I would say la. Instead of pequeño, I would say pequeña. So, small woman, la mujer pequeña. And see that motorcycle is an object, but is also feminine. So, if I want to say the small motorcycle, that would be la moto pequeña. And you see how the gender of the nouns, either hombre, auto, mujer, or moto, affects all the other words related to these nouns. And this is a rule that is going to help you a lot. Most of the masculine nouns end in o, and most of the feminine nouns end in a. So, o, masculine, a, feminine. But all the rules have exceptions. As I told you just now, most of the masculine nouns end in the letter O, but also the nouns ending in ma, pa, and ta can be masculine. So, O, ma, pa, ta, masculine. Example, chico, it ends in O, masculine. Programa, it ends in ma, masculine. Papa, with the capital P, that is the Pope, it ends in pa, that's why it's masculine. Planeta, it ends in ta, so it's masculine. Now, if the noun ends in a, ion, or the letter D, then most likely is going to be feminine. Examples. Chica, it ends in a, feminine. Televisión, it ends in ion, feminine. Libertad, liberty, freedom, it ends in the letter D, feminine. Many nouns that end in a consonant form the corresponding feminine, adding the letter A. So, profesor, profesora, señor, señora, guyanés, male Guyanese, guyanesa, female Guyanese, profesor, profesora, señor, señora, guyanés, guyanesa. Certain nouns have only one form, and that form works for masculine and for feminine. It's the same word for masculine and for feminine. If I say estudiante, that can be male student or female student. Elefante, it can be male elephant or female elephant. Recepcionista, it can be male receptionist or female receptionist. Mesa is feminine. Libro is masculine. Do you remember that when we were studying the colors, I told you that many of those have two versions, one for masculine and one for feminine? Yes, I'm sure you remember. For example, red, rojo for masculine and roja for feminine. So how would you say red table? La mesa roja, because table is feminine. So the adjective has to be feminine too. How would you say the red book? El libro rojo. Libro is masculine. That's why the adjective has to be masculine too. That is what we call concordancia in Spanish. Agreement. If you want to say the cat is small in Spanish, you have to know if the cat is masculine or feminine, because the cat in small can be said in two different ways. If the cat is masculine, el gato es pequeño. And see that I use the masculine ending for gato, that is the O, and the corresponding adjective, that is pequeño. But the female cat is small, I wouldn't say el, I have to say la. I cannot say gato ending in O, I have to say gata. And I cannot say pequeño ending in O, I have to say pequeña. So the female cat is small, la gata is pequeña. We have been talking about the articles during this whole class. In English, you have only definite article, that is the. In Spanish, we have two for the singular, depending on the gender of the noun. When the noun is masculine, that definite article in Spanish is el. But when the noun is feminine, the same definite article that in English would be the, in Spanish is la. So the can be translated as el for masculine, la for feminine. It happens the same for the indefinite article. The indefinite article in Spanish is un for masculine, una for feminine. So we say el suéter, un sombrero. This sweater, a hat. La blusa, una chaqueta. The blouse, a jacket. Escribe M, that means masculino, o F, that means femenino, según corresponda. Write M or F accordingly. Madre, regalo, mapa, problema, amiga, libertad, padre, televisión, mano, día. And remember all the rules for the gender that we studied before in this same class. Now, ejercicio 5, página 19. Conteste según el modelo. Answer according to the model. Es un bolígrafo. It's a pen. Between parentheses, lápiz, pencil. And you have to write. No, no es un bolígrafo. No, it's not a pen. Es un lápiz. It's a pencil. And remember to use the correct article in front of the second noun. Uno, es una chaqueta, camisa. Dos, es una mujer, hombre. Tres, es una falda, vestido. Cuatro, es un sombrero, blusa. Cinco, es una naranja, reloj. And now the final exercise for the class. El ejercicio final. Ejercicio 6, página 20. Completa las oraciones con él o la. Complete the sentences with él o la. 1. Estudiante es rubia. 2. Profesor de matemáticas es guapo. 3. Clase es buena. 4. Reloj es negro. 5. Lápiz es amarillo. 6. Puerta es blanca. 7. Motocicleta es negra. 8. Automóvil es nuevo. 9. Casa es grande. 10. Sombrero es rojo. And remember that you have a vocabulary with all the words that you will be studying in this course at the end of the book Dos Mundos. Y este es el momento de la tarea. Now, tarea time. 1. Descríbase usted. Describe yourself. 2. Describa a una de las siguientes dos personas. Describe one of the two following people. The first person is Isabel II del Reino Unido, the Queen Elizabeth. And the second person is an Italian actor, Michele Morrone. Recuerden que la próxima clase es una sesión en vivo en Zoom. The next lesson is an online session on Zoom, so remember to bring your questions. Este es el final de la clase número 3. This is the end of the class number 3. Nos vemos en la próxima sesión. Chao.